what is the diameter of this piece, which is the diameter of the hole of this, and it is also how much is the length of this from this center. It is the center of mass, friction, it plays very important role and it continues like this. So if you have few more, you just put it, when they go simultaneously, you can see they will continuously heat it and go down. It's only because there's some friction. When it goes down because of gravity, but when it tries to go down, it doesn't go straight away. So there's some friction in between these two parts. Friction is nothing but it is the opposition to the motion, and when it becomes like this, its center of mass gets disturbed, then again it becomes like this, then again its center of mass get disturbed. So every time it will continue. It is a very good balance between a stable center of mass. So it continuously keeps on doing peaking to this central portion. So again, you can make it. Tomorrow I will show you how to make it. Whatever the material you have, from that material also you can make it. See, if you put all of them together, you will find that they will maintain certain distance. See, this friction is equally important. If then I will go. This is again our traditional toy. Some of you must have seen. In different areas it has a different name. It's called stand up man, stand up girl, or sometimes in some portion of the some part of the country it's called besharmi. So the principle of this is very simple. Some of you must be knowing there is something called center of mass, and you have the definition, the point where the whole mass of body is supposed to be concentrated and all that. But what is it? If you see this toy, the mass here is much more dense, and mass of this top portion is very less. So the more mass is this side. So it always, for balancing, that center of mass has to be close to the ground. So for that, it always try to be a vertical. So even if you disturb its position, it will try to be vertical. And there are modern, this is the modern version of that. It is a Mickey Mouse. If you just remove this, you will find it's nothing but simple container. There is a sand filled in this, and because of that, this lower part is very heavy and this top portion is very light. So it tries to be in vertical position because its most of the mass is concentrated in the bottom. So you can make it with the our old bulbs are there. So with those bulbs you can make a toy like this. So it's again based on center of mass. Almost all of you must have seen this type of toy. वो जो झूला रहता है ना बच्चों का, छोटे बच्चों का, उसके ऊपर लगाया रहता है. And it has different versions also. It has a tabletop version. You can hang it, and it has different ways of spinning it. Some of them are spring based. Some of them are with a gear. All that. But you see, just when I spin it, what happens? Now you have to tell me what is it which makes in normal position when it's not spinning, they are vertical. Now When they start spinning, they spin because there is a potential energy in this rubber, so it tries to unwind. When it unwinds, this vertical strings from their min position or normal position, they try to go away. Why it is so? Any one of you?
Centrifugal force.
Again, centrifugal force, same thing. So the thing which worked in this, that hover one sphere, it is same thing. So this simple toy, which you see from our childhood, it has a science. And every, as I told you, every toy has some science. So you should try to understand it. And see, this is a mechanism some people use for rotating. See, it got spoiled. There is a spring here, spiral spring here. So when you turn it, it stores some potential energy. And when you release it, it tries to unwind it, and because of that, this shaft spins, and the toy also is attached to it, that also spins. This is one more toy, very simple toy but very interesting toy. You just see, I will just release it, it jumps. Just see, it's very lightweight. The material, and it's non-metallic, it is a simple plastic. You just see, when I release it, it jumps. The question is, why it jumps? This material has some property. Because of that, when I press it, it will get deformed. But when I release it, it will try to regain its shape. What is that property? Rubber has certain property. What is that property?
Elasticity.
It is something similar to this. When I press it, it stores some energy that is called potential energy. The potential energy is the energy because of its position. So when I press it, it will store some energy. It will work as a spring. And when I release it, it will jump. Now it will again depend on how much is the mass of this. If it is too heavy, mass is too high, spring action may not be enough for jumping it. So the person who designed this had made sure that properties of this material are optimized. It has to be lightweight. At the same time, the spring action of this plastic has to be enough to throw that whole mass upright. Okay. There is another toy. Most probably some of you must have seen this. It's a very interesting toy. There is a monkey and there is a thread here. Now, if I pull this thread, that monkey will go up. What could be the reason? Just to make it more clear, I have deliberately cut open this portion of the same toy, and all of we learn this, there is something called simple machines, and the simple machines help us in different ways. They reduce our efforts, at the same time they make our whatever the force we are applying, we can apply it in convenient direction. And one of the simple machine is pulley. There is a pulley inside this. In fact, there are two pulleys, what we call it a compound pulley. There are two pulleys side by side and they are having same axle. But the thread which appears to be one here is not one thread. There are two threads. This top one is different and that bottom one is different. The top one goes in one of the pulley and the bottom one goes in another pulley. So when I pull it down, the one which is on one of the pulleys gets unwind and the one which is at the another pulley gets wind. So when this one pulley moves like this, another pulley moves in opposite direction. So the thread which is wind will get unwind and the thread which is unwind will get wind. So when I pull it down, see, this is a problem with these toys. During transit, when I pull it, it will unwind and the top one will get wind. But when I release, when I reduce the tension in the this bottom spring, then because of gravity, it will come down and it will again, the top one will unwind and that bottom one will get wind. So it continues like that. And another thing is, there is a shaft on the circumference of the pulley and which is attached to this hands and legs of this monkey. So because of that, it has a circular motion, it translated into a linear motion. It goes forward, backward, and because of that, you